Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode of SciShow. Go to brilliant.org/scishow to learn how you can take your STEM skills to the next level with their interactive courses. If you've ever been to a tide pool, you have probably seen a chiton, even if you didn't know it. Chitons are basically flat, oval-shaped snails that creep along rocks in the ocean. And they specialize in scraping algae off those rocks, using a tongue-like structure embedded with two rows of teeth. And because their teeth are constantly scraping a rock, they have evolved to be made of something a lot stronger than calcium. Chitons have teeth made of materials like the metal magnetite. One species even uses a metal that until recently was only thought to be found in rocks. Turns out these animals make the hardest, stiffest biominerals of any living thing scientists have seen, and they are showing us what life is capable of. The chitin's tongue-like structure is called a radula, and in terms of design, the teeth embedded in the radula are surprisingly similar to human teeth. They're made of two pieces. You got the softer, flexible stylus, which is long and hollow, and connects the top of the tooth to the radula, similar to how the roots of our teeth hold them into our jaws. Then there is the hard cusp. This is what chitons use to scrape algae off rocks, and it's similar to the hard part of our teeth that we use to crush food. Except, if we were grinding our teeth on rocks, our teeth would wear down pretty fast because our calcium-based enamel is very soft compared to stones. So chitons have cusps made of a metal other than calcium, magnetite. It's actually the hardest, stiffest mineral made by a living thing that we know of. But some chitons don't even stop there. A study published in 2021 on the gumboot chitin revealed that their stylus contains a different mineral, and a very rare one at that. It's called Santa Barbarite, named for an area in Italy, not the city in California. Sorry to all you Santa Barbarinos. This mineral was thought to only exist in tiny amounts in rocks. But then, it was discovered inside this chitin stylus, mixed in with a relatively more soft, flexible material called chitin. That's chitin with an I, not to be confused with the animal we are currently discussing. The chitin sounds the same, but is O-N. Not confusing at all. Researchers believe this mixture helps make the gumboot stylus strong and flexible while staying lightweight, a perfect combination for a life licking rocks. That said, chitin teeth aren't invincible. Even magnetite teeth wear out, so the chitin's radula is constantly producing new ones. For how they do it, it's a process. The teeth actually start out transparent because they're only made of proteins and that flexible chitin. Then, as they age, they turn reddish-brown and then black. That color change happens through a process called mineralization. Here, particles of iron in the chitin's teeth are converted into an iron compound called ferrohydrite. Then, in the cusp, that ferrohydrite is converted into magnetite, and the teeth become black and reach their maximum hardness. Overall, chitins are a great example of just how much life can adapt just to a specific niche. These flat, unassuming creatures are so adapted to their rock-grazing way of life that they have evolved to make minerals we have never seen an animal make before. Which, if you ask me, is pretty metal. And something that's even more metal is learning about the chemistry metals can do with today's sponsor, Brilliant. They've overhauled their courses to be even more interactive, like this one about chemical reactions, where you can work through all the bits and bolts of chemistry, including chemical kinetics, where you'll learn how things like molecules interact and transform. If you're interested, you can get started at brilliant.org/scishow to get 20% off an annual premium subscription, and checking them out also helps us too, so thank you.